This conference will now be recorded.
Hello, good morning to everybody. Today revision class, unit 2 of microprocessor and microcontroller. Unit 2 is 8086 programming. The contents of this unit: addressing modes, instructions of 8086, assembler directives, program development steps, writing simple programming with an assembler, assembly language programming development tools by using TASM, Turbo Assembler, or MASM, Micro Assembler. Before discuss this unit content, in previous examinations, number 2019, regular and supplementary examinations, in November 2019, in part A, B question, list the steps in developing an assembly language program. It's a 2-mark question. In part B, third question, explain the different logical instructions of 8086 microprocessor. That means I discuss a logical instruction set of 8086, 7 marks. Write a short note on assembler directives. That is a 7 marks question. In regular exams, April, May 2019, what is immediate addressing mode of 8086? Explain with an assembler assembly instruction. What is the use of lock prefix in 8086 programming? In set 2 question, explain push and pop instructions. Sorry, in induction and I put instructions with examples. In set 3, discuss the use of assembler directives of EQ, offset, NP, and LEN assembler directives. In set 4, part A questions. In part B questions, in regular exams 2019, April and May, write the discuss different machine language instruction formats supported by 8086 microprocessor. Write an assembly language program in 8086 to find the factorial of a given number. In set 2, what are addressing modes? List different addressing modes supported by 8086 and explain with a suitable examples. What is the purpose of AAA, AAD, and DAA instructions of 8086? Explain with examples. In set 3, list different arithmetic instructions of 8086 microprocessor and explain with examples. Write a program in 8086 to convert a 16-bit binary number into equivalent BCD numbers in set 3. In set 4, write an assembly language program to find out the number of positive numbers and negative numbers from a given list of 16-bit signed numbers. What are the assembler directives? Explain any 7 assembler directives supported by 8086 in set 4. These are the questions asking in previous examination question papers. Before in-depth discuss of this unit content, how to instruction is executed in 8086, step-by-step process. the flow diagram you are observed. The first, your program code assume available in a external memory 1 MB, the location 20 bit 23450, that is the 20 bit hexadecimal or 5 digit of the hexadecimal 23450. It is a 20 bit lower order sequence, lower order 4 bits of the code segment starting address is the 0. Now this address is the popped up to the arithmetic unit of the bus interfacing unit, generated as the 20 bit base address. Generally here is indexed by the upper 16 bits, assume 2345, that is the converted into the binary form. Every digit is the 4 bits of the binary form, hexadecimal of every digit. 00102, 3 stand for the 0011, 4 stand for the 0100, 5 stand for the 101. In VIU, arithmetic unit multiplied CS value in terms of 16 are logically shift left side 4 bits or appending 4 zeros in rightmost of the CS content. We get the 20 bit base address. And second step, access the IP address. That is the indicate access the IP address. Assume your content is the referred within the code segment 4321 location, within the code segment. The starting address of the code segment you are assume 23450. From 23450, your reference content within the segment referred IP. The IP is the 4321 accessed by the arithmetic unit, that is the a 16 bit added to the base address 23450 of the code segment 4321. We get 20 bit address, that is the 27771, that is a 5 digit of the hexadecimal digits, 5 digits of hexadecimal. These 5 digit of hexadecimal carried on data bus to the bus control unit, carried to the address bus 20 bit and transferred to the bus control unit. Bus control unit enable the memory that address is the referred to the 2771. That content read by the bus control logic transfer to the instruction queue. From the instruction queue, execute unit is the run decoded that fetching content from the memory location 2771. The decoding of the control unit generated as the control signal enable the corresponding internal registers along with arithmetic logic unit. This is the process for execution of instruction in 8086. First, calculate the physical address of the code or instruction based on the CS and IP. We get a 20 bit address. The 20 bit address enabled the internal memory location, external memory location, that content transfer to the queue, from the queue transfer to the execute unit, and execute unit decode the control signals and enable the corresponding internal registers and ALU. This is the function for execution of the instruction in 8086. Now the next, how to represent data values in 8086 programming contents. Generally there are 4 ways represented a content: binary form, decimal, hexadecimal or octal digits. By hexadecimal, the suffix of the every digits added by H. Decimal digits are represented as the D. Binary value are represented as the B. Octal value is represented as O. Now the plus or minus is the optional sign. Default is treated as the positive. For example, 30 D, D is indicated as the decimal. 6A hexadecimal. 42 without any adjacent labels of the H, D, B, O, it is treated as decimal value. 1101 B is referred to the binary. Hexadecimal value, any value started by the letter before must inserted by the zero. If any hexadecimal value started by the integer, they're not required to the zero. Or alphabetic values are started, that are the A to F, before you are must added by zero. Now characters and strings are represented in 8086 comments. Within the single quotation encloses the character in single or a double quotes. Every character, it is treated as the one byte size or ASCII character. Our group of characters also indicated encloses by the double quotation or single quotation. Each character occupies a single byte space in memory. Here is the four characters, there are reserved 4 bytes. Our embedded codes also treated as the ASCII characters. For example, here is the VBT. Codes are enclosed within the single codes. These codes also indicated as ASCII character. Now here is the say welcome to VBIT. The VBIT is the enclosed by double quotes. It is the treated as ASCII value. These are the represented characters or a string constant of 8086. Now the labels, you are represented labels of the numbers in data segment act as the place marks that are the indicated as the code and data. Data labels must be unique. Example, a number 1, number 2 are your optional, whatever may be, except in the reserved mnemonics. Code labels. Within the program code data, code segmentation, you are moving either forward jumping or missing of the sum statement or backward. That are the indicated labels followed by the colon L1. L1 here is the indicated either forward jumping label or backward jumping labels. Data allocation. A amount of storage required. It is a 1 byte. Depending on your information, or 2 byte, or 3 byte, or and you are indicated a size of the a data representation. A labels to identify the storage allocated starting address, that are the responses or values. Now here is the indicated, there are represented 4 digits, there are 4 digits of the value. It is interpreted as the, here is the 16-bit value, negative value, that are the -29,255, or it is a positive value 36,281 as unsigned number. For signed number, MSB bit is a reserved remaining, a 15-bit represented a magnitude of the a number. In 8086, data represented by the 5 ways. 5 assembler directives are there. One is indicated as the DP, that means a defined byte, or it is a reserved 1 byte of memory space. DW, it is a defined word, it is a reserved or allocated 2 bytes memory space. DD, defined double words or allocates 4 bytes of memory space. DQ, defined quad words, or it is allocated 8 byte memory space. DT, defined 10 bytes, allocates a 10 bytes a memory space. For example, here is the label of the data sorted. The size is declared as the DP, indicated quotation. The value of the data is ASCII quotation byte. It is a reserved 1 byte memory space. Another variable, response. It is also 1 byte memory space. Question mark, that is indicated as the no initial value. It is the default empty or set by the zero. The next value, it is the DW25159. In any value greater than the decimal 255, it is treated as the 16-bit, or less than to the 65,535. Here is the 25,159. It is a less than to the 65,535. And greater than to the 255, it is the reserved 2 bytes of memory space. Therefore, the label is the referred to the DW. Now, a multiple variables are declared. Example here, DB, for example, BBIT, there are four characters are reserved for bytes of memory space. V is the indicated 1 byte memory space. Another V is the indicated as the 1 byte memory space. I is the reserved to the 1 byte memory space. T is the reserved to the 1 byte memory space. OD and OAH, these are the carries the return line paid. If it is a need or not optional. R can be written as DB in a single horizontal line, separated with quotations, separated with comma. V quotation, it is ASCII character. Another V quotation, ASCII character. I ASCII character, T. And end is the return character or line paid characters. Or more compactly as a message, a DB quotation, single quotation, you are simply writing to the BBIT. It is the reserved 4 bytes of memory space. Or another, a dupe assembler directives allows a multiple initialization to the same value. Multiple initializations, it is assigned to the a multiple memory locations is reserved by using a dupe assembler directives. Now, for example, table 1, it is the reserved table DW 10 dupe question mark. This is the reserved to the 10 words memory space in the memory location. The next DB, it is a 3 dupe. Here is the indicated as the by. The Y, again, apostrophe, there are 4 characters memory space is the reserved. This 4 is the duplicated by the 3 times. Therefore, 4 into 3, 12 bytes are initialized as internally 12 bytes. By apostrophe, by apostrophe, by apostrophe. It's repeated by the 4 times. Yes, sir. 3 times. 3 into each string size is the by 4 characters. 4 into 3, there are 12 bytes memory space is a reserved. Again, name 1, DB, it is a reserved 30. 30 bytes of the memory location is the reserved, initialized to question mark. There is no any value entered to the 30 memory locations. The dupe directly may be also be the dupe directive may also be nested. For example, 4 dupe, 3 dupe. Here is the indicated as 3, 2, 5. There are repeated these all values. There are 3 plus 2 plus 5. 10 repeated by the 4 times. That is the reserved 40 bytes space and initializes its as. Here is the 3 dupe, there are entered 3 stars. Again, 2 dupe, 2 question marks. 5 dupe, apostrophe, there are repeated 5 times. These values are repeated by the 4 times. Again, 4 into 10, total is indicated 40 characters. There are reserved 40 bytes memory space. Or, here is the another way representation matrix, DW 10 dupe, 5 dupe. There are reserved 5, it is a nested to the 10 dupe. There are totally is indicated 50 memory, 10 into 5, there are 50 memory locations are the reserved in the memory location. These are the corresponding to C data types. DB is the indicated defined byte, that are the character, DW, integer or unsigned in the C language, DD, it is a floating or long integer value representation, DQ, double integer value length, at TQ, it is a floating value, it is an internal intermediate value defined. In 8086, data stored or in a Intel Corporation, data is loaded by the Little Endian order. Little Endian order means your content stored from stored into the memory from lower digit to the upper digit. But human psychology, you are writing the content from upper digit to the lower digit. But in the 8086, the content stored into the little endian. For example, here is the value 1 dd. That means as there are reserved for the 4 bytes of the memory. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Assume there are load this content into the 20th thousand memory location. First is the loaded by the lower byte 78. The next is the loaded by the 56 adjacent of the lower byte. The next is the 34. And last is the loaded by the higher byte. This is concept is called a little endian. Or in AMD processors, the content is stored from the higher byte to the lower byte. That are means first is the loaded by the 12, the next is the loaded by 34, next is the loaded by the 56, next is loaded by 78. That is called big endian order. But all Intel versions are supported for the little endian order. Started content stored into the memory from the lower byte to the upper byte, or read the content, it is also same from lower byte to the upper byte. That is the indicated as the little endian concept. Next, addressing modes. Addressing modes, operands required by an operation can be specified in variety of ways, or simply, the way of representation of the operands is called addressing modes. The way of representation of the operands may be registers, or may be a value, or may be a memory location. The way of representation shows the different addressing mode. Operands in a register, that is the register addressing mode. Operand in the instruction itself, it is the immediate addressing mode. Operand in a memory, variety of addressing mode. Operand at an IO port, that are the directly access 16-bit port address by using in and out commands. Now the first addressing mode in 8086, register addressing mode. Operand is an internal register. Source and destination, both are the represented internal registers of 8086. Now for example, move BX, CX. Here is the CX is the source point, BX is the destination point. The CX content copied into the BX. Now move is the indicated in 8086 mnemonic or operation code. BX and the CX are the operands. CX is the source operand, BX is the destination operand. Both are represented as the registers. The name is called a register addressing mode. This statement is supported as the register addressing mode. The addressing mode only depending on the source and destination content. It is not depending on the mnemonics. Mnemonic here is using mode, or another mnemonics, add BX, CX. It is also register addressing mode. Or your load AX content, BX. It is also register addressing mode. The source operand and destination operand, both are the registers, is called a register operand. Now, the second example, move AL, CL. That means CL content transfer to the AL. After transfer the content, CL content keep it. There is no change, only updated by the AL content. It is the 8-bit copy. The second addressing mode is the immediate addressing mode. Immediate addressing mode is a part of the instruction. Data is the part of the instruction. Operand is located in the code segment along with the instruction, typically used a specified constant. For example, a move AL, 75. Here, the source operand is the 75. Destination operand is the register. The content 75 or value 75 loaded into the AL. This instruction uses a register addressing mode. Destination is the register addressing mode, and source is the indicated as the value or content, that is called immediate addressing mode. Therefore, overall, the conclusion of this statement supported as the immediate addressing mode. The third, direct addressing mode. Data is in the data segment, that means a memory. Need a logical address to access the data. Logical address means there are bifurcation of the address, segment address and also offset address. Represented segment colon offset, that is the two components. You get the physical address. Various addressing modes to specify the offset component. You are defined to the directly, or you are defined to the indirectly, or defined into the register addressing mode, or defined by the base addressing mode, or defined by the indexed addressing mode, or defined by the base indexed addressing modes. Now here, offset path is called effective address. The offset means the variation of the address within the segment is called offset or effective address. Offset is specified directly as part of the instruction represented in rectangular brackets, that are the open rectangular and closed rectangular box. Now we write an assembly language programs using memory labels is the declared in the data segment, size of the labels a DB or DW, whatever. Assembler compute the offset value for the labels based on the labels. Now for example, here there are three numbers I am declared in the data segment. Number one, size is the DB. Number two, the size is indicated as the 1, 2, 3, 4. Assume the origin of the data segment, origin offset address is the reserved to the number one. In any segment, the origin address is 40 hexadecimal. That means 16 binary forms, 16 zeros. Ended by the segment 4Fs or 16 ones. In segment size, 65,536 bytes or 64 kilobytes. Now here declared one of the segment by using assembler direct to segment. The name of the segment is the data. The origin offset address is the reserved to the number one. That means it is the reserved offset value, origin offset value 000H. In number one. Number two, the consecutive memory location of the number one is the reserved to the number two. That means it is a 001H is a reserved to the number two. Number two plus one, that is the 0002. Number two plus one, number two is the reserved offset value is the 001. Plus one means 002. It is the reserved number 2 plus 1, that is the indicated as the 002. Number 3, the consecutive memory location after the number 2. The consecutive memory location after 002 is the indicated as the 003. Is the reserved for the number 3. This is the indicated memory reserved for the 3 labels. Now here, assembler, you are using move AL comma number one. Due to the running time, number one is the replaced by writing into the within the rectangular brackets that are the 000H. But normally you are writing the text is indicated move AL comma number one. But due to the running time, the number one offset value is assigned as number one. That means AL comma 00. That means 00 offset of the data segment content transfer into the AL. In previous example, number 1, 24, the 24 transfer to the AL. Or you are using number 3, move AL comma num 3. The 45 is the loaded into the AL. Or move AX comma number 2. AX is the loaded by the 001 content. AL is the loaded by the 001 content. AX is the AH is the loaded by the 002 content. 001 is the loaded by the 34. 002 offset is the loaded by the 12. After execution, the statement move AX comma number 2. The consecutive two memory location that are the 001 and 00 memory 2 content transfer into the AL. Now how to calculate? For example, here is the indicated another the previous is the load the content from the memory to the internal register of the 8086. The second example, AX content is loaded to the offset. Here is also with the labels or your indicated rectangular bracket numerical value. Now DS value is multiplied with 10H, that means as the hexadecimal value 10H, that means as the decimal 16. Multiply DS value, DS is the indicated hexadecimal notation, shifted one digit left side and added the displacement. The displacement here is indicated as the 7000. Now DS value 1000 multiplied with 10, the rightmost added by the 10, that means 10000, added by the displacement value. Displacement value is the 7000, therefore 17000. Now AL content, that first is loaded by the lower order byte, that is called a little endian 34. The next is loaded by the higher byte. Within the upper end, you are directly represented offset of the data segment or effective address of the data segment is called direct addressing mode. Another addressing mode is the register indirect addressing mode. Within the statement, in previous example, offset address represented within the upper end, but here this upper end represented in registers. One of the registers, either BX or base pointer or source index or DI, these are the four registers used for register indirect addressing mode. Indirect addressing mode. Move DL comma, here is example, move DL comma within the brackets, it is a square brackets, within the square bracket SI. SI content treated as SI content referred as the offset address of the data segment. The data segment transfer into the DL. Now memory address is calculated as follows, either DS or SS. Is multiplied with 10, that means DS and SS is loaded by the higher order 16 bit of the base address, it converted into the 20 bit base address, multiplied with 10, added by the offset address referred into the either BX or SI, DX and BP, we get the 20 bit physical address, that content to transfer into the DL, that means a register addressing mode. Now here a SI is indicated as the 2000, DS is indicated as the 800. We get physical address based on this data segment address and SI. DS is logically multiplied with 10H left. Zero A, one digit added by the 2000, we get the 00 available in content is the 12, that content transfer to the referred register in the statement destination DL loaded by the 12. Now work out example to assume SS value is indicated as the 800H, BP is indicated as the 2000, represent DL value is indicated as the 7. Now here DL content loaded into the BP off, BP off is referred to the same address 80800 and 2000, we get the same address. Now the DL content is the 7 loaded into the memory, 12 is replaced by 7. Now the next register, another example, registers, register indirect addressing mode. Here is the main advantages array content referred. For example, first cumulative of the array content, let us the sum of all elements in an array, assume move BX comma table 1. The table 1 is directly referred the first two memory location content loaded into the BX. First I am load the offset value of the table 1, move BX comma offset table, offset is indicated as the assembler. Table starting address is loaded by the BX. But in the previous statement, move Vx comma table 1 means the table first two content loaded into the Vx. But here is the move Vx comma offset table 1 means the table starting address loaded into the Vx, or you are using LEA command, load effective address. LEA Vx comma table, that means the starting address of the table is loaded into the Vx. Either move Vx offset table 1 or LEA Vx comma table 1, it is the loaded starting address of the table into the Vx. Now first you have accumulated Vx, the next statement you are added, add AL comma within the bracket, a rectangular bracket Vx. The Vx starting element added to the AL. The next increase BL, a loop return to the loop, before loop increases Vx and return to the back, and so on of recursive times of the index, same content, array content is the report used for this addressing mode. Next, based addressing mode. In the previous register addressing mode, based addressing mode, both are the same except relative address. Move AX comma without relative, here is the relative means plus 4. Offset added again plus 4, without plus 4 it is treated as the simple register addressing mode. The main difference in between base addressing mode or indexed addressing mode or register addressing mode with the relative addressing along with base register is called base address, with the relative addressing along with the index register, that is called index register. Without relative, either SIs or DIs or BX or base pointer, it is treated as a simple register addressing mode. Now move AX comma BX plus 4. Here, our physical address is calculated, segment address is multiplied with 10, added by the BX content plus 4. We get the new physical address, that content transfer into the specified register, that means AX. Now here, a move a DI comma, here is the example, move DI comma 8 comma, move DI minus 8 comma BL. BL content is loaded into the DI minus 8 memory location. Now the DI is referred to the 300. Now displacement 008, subtracted 8, we get the 28, added by the 20. Now 2028. Your content is loaded by the 2028. Now some relative, either addition or subtraction, refer to the base address or base registers, that is called base addressing mode, or index registers, that means as the indexed addressing mode. Based indexed addressing mode, here the combined the base register and source, we get the new offset value of the data segment. Your AH content in loaded to the in that new offset value. Here is the base pointer and SI added by the BP plus SI, we get the new offset of the data segment. AH content is loaded in that. That is called based indexed addressing. Now based indexed with displacement, here the new offset generated as the BX plus DI plus 2080. We get the new offset value of the data. That new offset value content transfer into the CL. Now these are the memory reference address. One is the indicated, it is a summary of the memory reference addressing, either direct or indirect. Indirect is the register based indexed or based index. Now you are observed to the register indirected based addressing mode, indexed addressing mode. Without displacement, the content of the registers referred to the offset is called a register indirect. The content of the register plus displacement of the base registers is called a based addressing mode. The content of the index registers and the displacement, it is treated as the new offset of the data segment. that is called indexed addressing mode. This is the main difference in between to the register versus to the based versus to the index. With the displacement, that is the treated as the based or indexed. Without a displacement, you are using BX or base pointer or SIDI. It is called a register indirect addressing mode. Based indexed is the combined both a BX register and SI or BX register and DI. It is a combined both BX register and SI with a displacement. These are the indicated based addressing mode. These are the memory content referred address locations. The next addressing mode is the string. Now in 8086, there are some special set of instructions are there that are called string instructions. That string instructions is indicated for the string addressing mode. In string addressing mode, the effective address of the source is referred to the SI. Destination effective address, that means offset address, referred into the DI. In normal commands, there is no transfer from memory to memory. That means a data segment source offset, destination of the source offset does not transfer from source offset to the destination offset. But in the string statement, transfer from source offset content to the destination offset content. The source offset content referred into the SI register, destination offset referred into the DI. Now here is the example, a move string byte, MOVSB, the simple form of the example, mnemonics of 8086, MOVSB or MOVSW, move string byte and move string word. There is no adjacent represented as the source index and destination index. Default, the effective address of the source index referred by the offset SI, destination is the DS. We get memory address, effective address is the SA, and base address is the referred to the DS is multiplied with the 16, 20 bit added by the effect address of the source. The destination memory address, effective address, source offset is the destination offset referred to the DI, base address of the destination referred to the ES, that means extra segment base address. In previous, source address is the indicated as the DS, destination address is referred to the ES, calculated for the physical address of the destination MAE. After the statement is executed, the base address of the source MA, that is the base of the data segment, and offset is the SI content transfer to the destination address referred to the ES and DI. After the statement is the transfer, SI and DI automatically either incremented or decremented depending on the direction flag. If direction flag is 1, after the statement is executed, SI value is the decreases by the 1. If DF is equal to 0, SI value automatically increases by the 1. Or you are using word statement, MOVSW, SI and DI either incremented 2 times or decremented 2 times depending on the direction flag. For direction flag, default 0, that means a forward movement. Our direction flag is the set by the statement std, direction flag is the 1, SI and DI value decreases by the 1, that means as the backward movement. Next, addressing mode of the IO ports. Directly we access content from the IO devices or to the IO ports using by the two statements in and out. Now in and out statements, the port address, there are two ways represented, 8-bit port address or 16-bit port address. 8-bit port is the indicated as the server port address, directly represented within the operand. Directly represented within the operand in square bracket. If the operand, Your I/O ports address is the greater than to the 8 bit. That means more than 255. That means ephemeral port address or temporary port address. The temporary port address referred into the indirect way through DX register. Now, for example, here in AL, 09H. Now, 09H is the less than or equal to 255 for decimal or FFH. Therefore, directly is mentioned. This is called direct port address. That 09 port content transfer to the EAL. In indirect way, if the port address is the greater than to the 16 bit, first you are load, for example, 1234, it is the 16 bit value. The 1234 content is the assumed, the output or monitor address. 1234 is the monitor address. Now you are represent out within the bracket 1234, comma, AX. AX content transfer to the monitor. It is an invalid statement. That means address is the 16 bit. If the address is the 16 bit, represented indirect way through DX mask. Before the statement is executed, out DX comma within the bracket DX comma AX, DX is the loaded by the 16 bit port address. Assume move AX comma 1234H. After that, move DX within the bracket comma AX. That means AX content transfer to the 1234. That means as the your output port. That is the indirect way. Therefore, I/O ports content is accessed by the direct port addressing mode or indirect addressing mode. The next, a relative addressing mode. In jumping statement, that is the conditional statement, you are either jumping forward or backward. Now here one example, jump 0, 0AH. 0AH is the offset address of the code segment. You are jumping to the 0AH. Directly. If the ZF flag is equal to 1, there is no jumping. It is a continuation of the. If the ZF is not equal to 1, it is a continue for the next statement. Does not jumping or skipping for the next 10 consecutive memory locations. Either you are jumping the based on the conditional statement, either forward jumping or backward jumping. For example, in the C language, using by the if statement, if for loop statements or while do or do while statement. That condition is the true, executed one type of the statement. Condition is the fail, executed another type of the statement. That is the process or change of the statement. That condition is called a relative addressing mode or that statement. All conditional statements are treated as the relative addressing modes. Next, implied addressing. There is no operand. The mnemonic is implied the address of the operand. That is called implied addressing mode. Example CLC. The statement is the shows clear carry flag. The mnemonic is indicated the location of the operation carry flag, clear carry flag. Similarly, set direction flag, STD. Similarly, INT, set direction flag or CLD, clear direction flag, NOP, no operation, halt. These are called implied addressing mode. There is no source operand or destination operand. Itself of the statement or mnemonics is called implied addressing mode. These are the addressing mode. In previous examination question, they are asking to the what are the different addressing modes and explain with examples. Now the next shall go to the instructions set of 8086. In 8086, there are six type of six sets of instructions are there that are data transfer instructions, arithmetic instructions, logical instructions, string manipulation instructions, process control instructions, control transfer instructions. These are six sets. In previous examinations, is asking explain any logical instructions supported 8086 or arithmetic instructions is asking with examples. Now first is the data transfer instruction. Instructions that are used to transfer data or address in a registers, within the registers, or memory to register, or from memory to memory locations, or I/O devices to the memory, or memory to the I/O devices, or register to memory, whatever may be the ways are represented, generally involves two operands for the data transfer. One is the indicated as the source operand, and second one is the destination operand. In data transfer operation, a data transfer instructions, source and destination size are must equal. That means both are the same byte or both are the same word. In 8086, data transfer size either byte or word. Word means as the 2 bytes. Word is not loaded into the byte, or byte is not loaded into the word destination memory. That means both are source and destination are must equal size. The source may be register or memory location or an immediate value or I/O ports, whatever may be the source, depending on the your addressing mode. Similarly, the destination, either register or memory or I/O ports, does not supported as the
does not. I'm ready, sir. I'm ready, sir.
Sir,
sir, meeting lock చేశారు sir, meeting. సార్
వస్తుందా వాయిస్?
వాయిస్ వస్తుంది సార్.
స్క్రీన్ వస్తుందా?
హలో,
స్క్రీన్ వస్తుందమ్మా?
స్క్రీన్ చూపిస్తుంది సార్, మీ ఫేస్ చూపించట్లేదు సార్ ఇప్పుడు. అది ఒకసారి మీటింగ్ ఒకసారి లాక్ చేయండి సార్. మీటింగ్ లాక్ చేశాను సార్, స్టూడెంట్స్ జాయిన్ అవ్వకుండా లాస్ట్ టైం అయిపోయింది. మీరు మీ డెస్క్టాప్ మీద మీటింగ్ అంటే నాకేం చూపించట్లేదు సార్, జస్ట్ మీ చేశారా సార్?
అన్లాక్ చేశా.
ఓకే సార్, ఓకే సార్, కంటిన్యూ సార్. సార్ ఒకసారి మీ వీడియో కూడా ఆన్ చేయండి సార్, కంటిన్యూ చేయండి సార్.
వీడియో ఆన్ లోనే ఉంది.
లేదు సార్, వీడియో ఆఫ్ లో ఉంది సార్, వీడియో చూపించట్లేదు సార్. ఒకసారి ఓన్లీ పీపీటీ ఒకటే చూపిస్తుంది సార్. ఓకే, ఓకే సార్, ఓకే సార్, ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్, కంటిన్యూ సార్.
The source, register or memory location, or an immediate data. Destination is the register or memory location. The size should be either byte or word, either 8-bit content or 16-bit content. The first example is in data transfer is MO. That means a register to register, or register to memory, or memory to a register. Or the second is the indicated for the data to register or data to memory. That means as the immediate addressing mode. The first is the indicated as the register to register. Example, MOVX, BX is the register addressing mode. Or a MOV within the brackets, a BX, a register. That means as the CX. That is called indirect addressing mode, or the indirect addressing mode, or register address, register indirect addressing mode. Now, whatever may be your addressing mode, the way of represented by the data transfer, MO, register to register, or memory to register, or register to memory, or register to data, or memory to data. These are the data transfer by using MO. The next is the exchange. Exchange register 1 content to the register 2, or swapping. the register one content to the register two, register content two to register one. That means as we're swapping of the two registers. Our second statement is the register to memory or memory to register swapping. The next statement is the pushing operation. In previous examination, they are asking in one set, explain the push and pop operations. Now push a 16-bit operation. Now here is in 8086, only pushed by the content 16-bit by 16-bit. Does not supported for 8-bit operation. Push AX, example. Now you are observed, before pushing content, first is updated the stack pointer. Stack pointer is the decreases by the 2. That means SP is the newly loaded by the after decreases current position. That means SP minus 2 unloaded by the SP. Based on that new SP value of the stack segment, offset value loaded by the your register content. Your 16-bit content is the loaded by the MA plus, that is the new offset value loaded by the MA plus 1 first value is the loaded, MA plus memory address plus source address, MA plus 2 is the loaded for the second address. Similarly, push memory content. First is updated the stack pointer. After that, updated a memory location loaded by the your represented memory location into the top of the stack segment. In pop operation, first retrieve the content from the stack to the specified memory or specified register. In previous, before pushing, stack pointer is updated. In pop operation, first is the read the content from the memory, from the register or from the top of the stack segment to the register or top of the stack segment to the memory after updated for the stack pointer increases by the 2. Here is the before updated the stack pointer. This is the differences in between to the push operation, pop operation. First is updated the stack pointer. After that, load the content from the top of the load the content to the memory from a specified register. Here is the load the content from the memory to the pop specified registers. That is indicated as the pop operation. Next, in and out. Now in AL comma DX, the port address indirect represented in the DX, that port content transfer to the AL, that means byte transfer. Here is the second statement, word transfer. Now in AL comma address 8-bit, the port address is the 8-bit, that content is loaded to the AL, or port address 8-bit, that content transfer to the 2 bytes AX. Similarly in the out, AL content loaded into the specified port address, output port address, referred into the DX are directly represented by the within the operand port address. AL content or AX content transfer to the specified register. Next, another important instruction in the data transfer in previous examinations is asking translate. That is the mnemonics is indicated XLATE. XLATE is the implied addressing mode. There is no operands represented, only mnemonics. XLATE, it is the syntax is the simple XLATE. The main XLATE function, BX should be loaded with the starting address of the translation table. Within the table, any address is a referred, similar to the in C language, X of I. X is the referred to the starting address of the table. I is the shows the within the table variation of the address. Similarly, in any table, the starting address referred to the BX. Within the table, the position starting element or middle of the element or end of the element, the table position within the table position referred into the AL. After the statement is executed, within the table, AL is the referred position, either first position or middle of the position or end of the position. That content is the loaded into the AL. This instruction read the byte at this indexed in the translate table and store the value in AL. Within the reference of the table, that content transfer into the default AL. That is indicated as the translate instruction. Next, arithmetic instruction. Add. Similar to the operands represented in 80 data transfer, a registers, memory, or IO ports, or content. The source operand may be registers, or memory, or IO ports, or content. Now here add a register two comma a register one. Register content, register one content added to the register two, and result is loaded into the register. The next. The data segment offset refer to the memory, that content added to the register 2 and loaded into the register 2. Similar to add memory or immediate addressing mode, add reg comma data. This is the immediate addressing mode, data content added to the register and result is loaded into the register. The second is also a immediate addressing mode or direct addressing mode. The data directly available in the operand, for example, move within the bracket 1234 comma 24. The 24 is loaded. 24 is added to the data segment 1234 content and result is loaded into the data segment 1234. This is the indicated add operation. Next add. Here is the refer to the syntax. ADC. The source is the register or memory. Destination is indicated as the register or memory. Now, the source operand is the register one, added to the destination operand along with the carry flag. If the carry flag is the zero, there is no difference add versus to the ADC. If the carry flag is the one, only one is difference for the add versus to the ADC. Additionally added for the carry flag status, either zero or one. The next is indicated as the subtraction. Here is the source operand is the register one. Destination operand is indicated as the leftmost operand. The rightmost operands are indicated as the source operand. Leftmost are indicated as the destination operand. The mnemonics is the sub. Now register one content subtracted from the register two, and result is loaded into the register two. In all arithmetic operation, enabled by the status flag. In data transfer instructions, does not enabled for the status flags. Next, subtraction with borrow. Here, the source operand along with the carry flag subtracted from the destination operand, result is loaded into the destination operand. That means SBB, subtraction REG minus SEF from the register one. That means the register, here is the indicated for the register one and carry flag subtracted from the register two. Similarly, memory and carry flag content subtracted from the register two. Register one and register carry flag subtracted from the memory. That means as the subtract with borrow. Next, incrementing. Increment is indicated only destination operand, that content added by the one and result is loaded by the one. In increment operation does not affected by the carry flag, remaining all flags are affected. That is the main differences increase versus to the add. Assume the destination operand, for example, AL is the FF add by AL 1. That means FF plus 1 we get the carry flag is the enabled. Similarly, increase AL before AL is the FF. After increases, AL is indicated as the zero, does not affected for the carry flag. That is the main differences increase versus to the add. In add, affected by the carry flag, in incremented does not affected for the carry. Similarly, in the decremented. Decrement is one. Next, in multiplication operation, in 8085 there is no multiplication operation are there. In 8085, sorry, in 8086 available multiplication. There are two type of multiplications are there: 8-bit multiplication or 16-bit multiplications. Now, for example, here is the report. Mul register, only source operand is the report. Destination operand referred by the EAX default. Mul EAL, EAL is the multiplied with EAL. Mul BL, BL is the multiplied with EAL and result is the loaded to the EAX. Mul CL, CL is the multiplied with EAL. Every source operand multiplied with accumulator default in the multiplication or IMUL. Now here is observed in the bottom diagram. EAL is the multiplier, 8-bit source, whatever may be your source, directly or a register or memory location multiplied with EAL. Result is the 8-bit loaded into the 8-bit. Result is the 16-bit, lower order is the loaded in the EAL, higher order is the loaded into the AH. Your 16-bit by 16-bit multiplication, maybe result is the 16-bit or 32-bit. If it is a 16-bit loaded into the AX, 32-bit is the loaded into the DX, multiplied with DX. Sorry, higher order 16-bit is the loaded into the DX. Now MUL and IMUL. Signed multiplication, you are using IMUL, except MSB bit multiplication or ARACA, including MSB bit multiplication, that is the indicated as the MUL, but that is the unsigned multiplication. This is the signed multiplication. The next is the indicated as the division. In 8086, there are two type of divisions are there: 16-bit by 8-bit or 32-bit by 16-bit divisions are there. 16-bit in division operation, here is the indicated for the source. The destination is the referred, that means as the dividend. Dividend always referred to the EAX. Divisor is the indicated as the source, whatever may be. You are indicated directly or register or memory. That is the device. Default, a dividend is the referred to the dividend. Depending on the, your 16-bit by 8-bit or 32-bit by 16-bit, depending on the source size. If it is the source is the 8-bit, your division 16-bit by 8-bit. If source is represented as the 16-bit, your division is the 32-bit by 16-bit. Now, for example here, DIV BL. BL is the 8-bit. Your BL, 16-bit by 8-bit, BL is the 8-bit. AX divisible by the BX, that means AX by BL. After division, coefficient is the loaded into the AL, remainder is the loaded into the AH. Or I am using DIV BX. Here BX is the 16-bit. Therefore, the division is occur 32-bit by 16-bit. The divisor first 16-bit referred into the AX. The higher order 16-bit is the referred to the DX. DX and AX divisible with BX. That is the divisor is the 16-bit. After division, coefficient is the 16-bit loaded into the AX. Remainder is the referred to the DX. That is the indicated as the division for the signed. Similarly, IDYV, that means as the unsigned divisions, except MSB bit is the division operation is provided. Next, comparison. Comparison and arithmetic operation. It is the logical comparison and subtraction, both are the same. In subtraction, after subtraction, the destination content is the change or overwriting the result. But comparison, there is no overwriting the destination, only affected for the carry flag, zero flag, and sign flag, that are the status flag. If register example, compare register 2 and register 1 in previous, in one example, let us assume, compare AX comma BX, AX is the register 2, BX is the register 1. If AX is the greater than to the BX, carry flag is the subtraction is possible. AX is the greater than to the BX. AX minus BX subtraction is the possible. The carry flag is the zero. Zero flag is not a result, is the zero. Sign flag is the positive. Result is the positive zero. Therefore, it is affected. Carry flag zero. Zero flag is the zero. Sign flag is the zero. Assume if AX is a smaller than to the BX, carry flag, it is a negative number is occurred with borrow subtraction. Carry flag is the enable. Sign negative number, result is the negative occurred. Sign flag is the one. Result is the non-zero. Zero flag is the zero. If AX is equal to BX, subtraction is possibility, does not require to the carry, does not occur to the a negative number. Therefore, a zero flag is also indicated. Sign flag is the zero. Zero flag is the only affected for the carry flag, zero flag, sign flag after the logical subtraction. Comparison means as the logical subtraction. After both are the same subtraction and comparison. Subtraction updated by the destination. Comparison does not updated for the destination. Next. Another important in asking in previous examination, AAA, AAD, AAS. The AAA means ASCII adjust after addition. This instruction adjusts the binary result of result after addition or add with carry or any arithmetic. For example, AAS for the supported arithmetic subtraction instruction. It makes the result in the AL. Only adjust the AL content for decimal representation. For example, add 8 and 2. That are the character representation. Move AH is the 0. AL is the loaded for the 8. ASCII value of 8 is the shows as 38. ASCII value of 2, quotation or quotation source, ASCII value. 2 is the indicated as the 32. 38 plus 32, we get 6A. Add AL by 2. 6AH. You are using the statement after addition, ASCII adjust after addition. AX is the shows 0100. That means the first lower nibble of the result, that means as the AL, A. Is the greater than to the 9 added to the 6. Auxiliary carry flag is the enable added to the 6. We get 8 plus 6 that are the indicated for the A plus 6 hexadecimal is the shows as the 10. Again, the carry is the propagated to the auxiliary carry propagated to the second digit. Second digit is the disabled. Auxiliary carry is the loaded into the AH. That is the result is assigned into the AH. Default is the loaded into the H. The carry value, if any, ends up in AH. Now A added by the 6, we get the carry. That carry is the transfer to the AH. We get 10100. Now R operation 3030. We get 3130. It shows as ASCII character. 30 is indicated as the 0, 31 is indicated as the 1. This is the ASCII adjust after addition. Similarly, ASCII adjustment after subtraction. Due to the subtraction, if any lower nibble is the greater than to the 9 subtracted by the 6, or higher nibble is the greater than to the 9, or carry flag is enabled subtracted by the 16. That is the indicated arithmetic carry flag. Next, AAM, ASCII adjusted after multiplication. Similar to after multiplication, for example, BL is the 5 and AL is indicated as the 6. You are multiplied 5 into 6, that is the 30. 30 is the hexadecimal is the 1E. You are using simple AAM, we get the 3000. Your answer is lower nibble, it is treated as the one digit of the decimal 0. Higher nibble is indicated as a higher byte is indicated as the higher, that is indicated as the 3. Lower byte is the single digit, that is called 0. Next is indicated as the 3. The next ASCII adjust before division. Before division, you are adjust the, you are using this statement. For example, 37, you are divisible by 25. For example, 25. I am division of the 25. Divisor is the 25. Dividend, sorry. Dividend is the 25. 25 equivalent hexadecimal value. Now, generally, is the treated as the 37. 37, move AX is the indicated as the 37. AH, AAD, that is the shows as the 25. Actually, is the indicated as the 3 and 7. It is the hexadecimal value. 37 at 25H. Move BL, DIV BL, we get the at 25 is the divisible 25, sorry. It is the 37 individual character. 3 is indicated as the 03, 07 is the 7. 37 decimal is equivalent to the hexadecimal is the 25. You are using AAAD. 2 hexadecimal, 16 into 2, that are indicated as the 32 plus 5, 37. Divisible by 5. Now, after division, there are possibility how many number of times? 7 times. Coefficient is the shows 7. Remainder is indicated as the 2. Except AAD, AAS, AAA, AAM, after the operation or arithmetic operation you are applying. Except AAAD, AAAD before the division is applied. Before division, you are using the AAAD. The remaining are the indicated after the operation. That are the indicated for the arithmetic ASCII adjustment. Next, DAA, DAA or DAS, decimal adjust after addition. If AL value is greater than 2 to the 9, or auxiliary carry flag is the 1, default added by the 1 to the AL, and auxiliary carry flag is the enable. Otherwise, AL value not greater than 2 to the 9, or auxiliary carry flag is the 1, auxiliary carry is the 0. If AL value is the greater than 2 to the 9, higher nibble, carry is the 1, AL is equal to added by the 60 and carry equal to 1, else carry is the indicated as the 0. For example, move AL comma 35, AL comma 38. You are summing of these values, we get 83. But hexadecimal is indicated as the 70. Add AL comma 48, 70. After you are using DAA, it is the D is converted into the hexadecimal. D is the indicated as the 13. The 13 is added to the 83, 7, 13 added by the 6, D6 is added 3, carry is the 1, 7 plus 1, 83. Similarly, AL is the 35, AL is the 65, we get 98. The lower nibble is greater than to the 9, added by the 6. 6, we get the added 0, 1 year. Again, A added by the 60, carry is the propagated. Carry flag 1 and AL is indicated as the 1. That means as the 100. That is the conversion from hexadecimal to BCD. You are using DAA. Similarly, DAS, decimal adjustment after subtraction. Next, logical operations. In 8086, there are AND, OR, XOR, and NOT. There are 4 logical instructions are there that are the performed logical bit by bit operations of the source along with the destination. Result is loaded into the destination. Another important of the logical instruction test. Test and both are the same. In AND operation, after the operation updated for the destination and also updated for the status flag. In test operation, there is no updated for the destination, only updated for the status flags. That is the main differences in between test versus to the AND. Both are the same, only affected for the destination and source. Here it is not affected for the destination. Next, a logical shift operation. Shift left, it is a number of count one time directly you are represented or more than one time that are indicated via CL. There are two types of the shift left and shift right. Now here is the indicated for the first flow diagram. Shift left. The LSB bit added by the zero. Remaining all bits, either 8 bit or 16 bit, shifted left side 1 bit position. MSB bit transferred to the carry flag. In shift right, MSB bit added by the zero. From the MSB bit, remaining all bits shift right side 1 bit position. LSB bit transferred to the carry flag. That means as the shift right. One time directly you are represented SHR, a destination variable, comma one. More than one time that value report to the CL. Next, shift arithmetic right. That means in previous shift right, MSB bit added by the zero. Here MSB bit around MSB bit. That is called rotate again MSB bit. From the MSB bit, remaining all bits is the shifted 1 bit right side. Before execution, MSB bit is the 0. There is no difference in between SAR and SHR. If MSB bit is the 1, differences in SHR and SAR. MSB bit is copied into the pushing into the right side. Next, rotate left and rotate right. Now here is the indicated rotate left with carry. Now here carry MSB bit enter to the carry flag. From the carry flag transfer to the LSB. From the LSB shifted to the left side. That is the indicated LSB. Similarly, rotate right. Carry flag is entered to the MSB bit. From the MSB bit rotated into the right. Without carry or with carry. There are two, ROL and ROR without carry. RCL and RCR with carry propagated. Next, string manipulations. In string manipulations, there are two ways, string byte or string word. The source offset referred to the SI. Destination offset is the referred to the DI. Source offset, source base address is the referred to the DS. Destination offset referred into the extra segment. Next, repeat string. In any statement, prefix you are using repeat. That is the repeated statement. The CL value is equal to zero. If CL value equal to zero, repeat the same statement number of times. Now, for example, MOVSB. That means move string byte. Source offset address and base address. The source base address in the DS, offset in the SI, that content transfer to the destination address referred into the ES base, offset in the DI. After transfer, SI value automatically either incremented or decremented depending on the IF. Similarly, MOVSW, word by word are transferred. There are two consecutive memory locations of the source offset transferred to the destination offset. After that, either incremented by the two times or decremented by the two times, depending on the direction flag. Before this statement, you are using repeat statement. Again, after by transfer, repeat before repeat this same statement, check the carry flag. If the carry flag is the zero, terminated that statement. If the carry flag is the one, terminated that step. Zero flag is the one, terminated the statement. If carry flag is non-zero, repeat the same statement. Similar to the comparison, scan, load, and STOS. Today come.
Hello. Sir.
Sorry.
Hello. Sir.
Sir, 12:30 in kada.
Ah.
Next, continue chestam. Okay. Thank you. Section will continue on the remaining instructions and 8086 interface. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Sir, meeting end yes, sir. Sir, hello. Sir, I'm ready, sir.